The power of your thoughts, mind, is very, very real, especially in regard to the people you keep in your circle. We tend to talk about this in terms of positive. You're the average of the five people that are close to you. You've heard that before. So you need to seek those who elevate you and spend as much time with them as possible. These are straight facts, folks. Your circle is very important to where you are in life. It's equally important, however, to look at things from the other side of that equation. What do I mean? There's also negativity in your environment and in that circle that causes even more damage. Often, however, we can't see it. The insidious nature of toxic creep can cloud the objectivity necessary to recognize that certain relationships are doing more harm than good. This is something against you must consciously fight. Toxicity affects you in profound ways, from your emotional state to your very perception of what's reality. And there are a few more attributes that are more valuable to perception that you need to recognize. In my own personal struggle with depression, it required me to get some attributes really quick to give myself the ability to spot and directly react to negativity in various ways. Sometimes that requires severing certain relationships. And I know that's easier said than done if you're in love or it's been a long established relationship, maybe even a business relationship. And a lot of us are resistant to change. No matter how often or how necessary, the lure of the familiar seems very preferable to upheaval, leaving us to loathe to make the obvious choice. But we have to, even if it means cutting people out of our lives. I know that's very hard and nothing is harder, but nothing is more important. And nothing I say will make sense or make it easier unless you start looking at your circle. And it has to be done. You need to look from all perspectives, emotional, psychological, social. There comes a point when cutting folks off is the key for both short-term happiness and long-term growth. Cutting anyone off or someone out of your life is painful, especially if there's history there, but there's a silver lining. And as in my experience, there's an equilibrium to life and the universe tends to balance the scales out for you. There's a quote that I think of when I think about cutting people off, and it goes like this. Before you even diagnose yourself with depression or low self-esteem or in a really low pace, first make sure you're just not surrounded by a bunch of assholes. Removing one person creates space for another. Usually you'll find that that new person brings you up instead of pulling you down. Always be checking who's in your circle. Always be checking who your enemies are. A lot of times your enemies are standing right next to you. You don't even know it. So really it's only by cutting out negativity that we can ultimately create the tribe we need to thrive. What's up, guys? My name's Coach Clarence. Please hit that like button and share with anyone you think this video might be helpful for. And if you're watching on YouTube, hit that gray bell so you'll be noticed every time I drop a video or a segment from the podcast so you know what's going on. I hope this video helps, and I'll see you folks next time. Have a great day.